Superheroes.
Where?
A bunny, princesses, and even a scary clown were found roaming neighborhoods for candy Saturday night.
There you go.
Many of them stopped at Steve Bowman's home in Greensboro.
I like to go outside and get some candy and dress up.
It's clear COVID did not kill Halloween this year.
What are you supposed to be this year?
Optimus Prime.
One by one, kids grabbed candy as much as they could.
We got some from our family, and then we got some from our friend, and then I think we're going to get some from him.
Parents got in on the fun, too.
I'm a shepherd.
I'm a sheep.
I heard that.
While driving through neighborhoods, I noticed there weren't crowds of trick-or-treaters, but people were finding ways to get out and enjoy the holiday.
We're not doing the trunk-or-treats this year or the big neighborhood trick-or-treating. You know, just safety, just staying close to home.
Some people started their Halloween earlier in the day at a trunk-or-treat festival at the Windsor Recreation Center.
I'm having a lot of fun out here trick-or-treating.
I'm going to have a lot of fun and share my fun with my family.
Other families dressed up for a drive-through trick-or-treat with Winston-Salem police. Vehicles lined up in the parking lot at Galilee Missionary Baptist Church on Northampton Drive.
I like it a lot. It's very creative. I didn't ever expect this to happen.
Officers ditched their uniforms for creative costumes and used grabbers to give out candy.
It's great. It's a lot different than it has been, but trying to get used to the new normalcies are a little tough, but something to do.
What they did, put smiles on kids' faces, one treat at a time. Jamisha Lyde, Fox 8 News.